The limbic arc spark scan requires a complex biometric input. We use voice as one of those inputs because voice carries a large amount of information. It changes with time and with condition, and voice is topic specific. Your voice energy actually changes depending on the topic you're speaking of. The other input we use is a kinetic response that's created by 5 mouse clicks or touches on the screen. We then take the biometric input and use it to generate a spark, and that spark ignites the algorithm that scans and ranks the InfoBoost ingredients in the library. Scan results are shown as a percentage, and that number appears next to each InfoBoost ingredient. Higher numbers indicate a more favorable scan result. Because the biometric input is dynamic, it only remains valid for 24 hours. After 24 hours, a new spark is required for a scan. This is how you run the spark scan. I've opened up the app, and on the first screen, you'll see under Active Info Boosts, I don't have any Info Boost active. Click on this button to add. And here are the Info Boosts that I can pick. Let me take Focus. And when I click on that, I have an option here to personalize it, or I can just take it as it is. Now, those of you who are familiar with the Info Boosts in version 1, the Info Boosts have a predetermined group of InfoBoost items in it, or InfoBoost ingredients. If I click on the Personalize My InfoBoost, it'll start a spark scan, and I'll show you how you then apply that. Once you click on the button, there's some instructions up here, gives you a little bit of information about it. We will continue. You can read all that when you open up yours. And it says, now we're going to take a voice frequency pattern, and we're not going to record the words you say. It doesn't matter what you say. But if it's just a general spark, you want to talk about yourself in terms of your name, your eye color, your hair color, how old you are, what's your birthday, what's your shoe size. Generally, describe yourself in a way that anybody who you know who walked in the room and saw you would be able to describe you. You don't want your mind to wander. You don't want to talk about yourself in terms of where you were born and where you were raised and how many brothers and sisters you have. So you keep the conversation on you personally. Now remember, voice is topic specific. So if I talk about a different topic, let's say I'm interested in creating an info boost because I'm having really bad allergies. Well, I could talk. When I do this voice pattern recording, I could talk about my allergies. I could say, you know, I'm sneezing, et cetera, et cetera. That would make the voice pattern recording specific to the issue that I'm trying to address. But as a general rule, you just talk about yourself. And so we're going to hit the button and away we go here. So let's see. It says it wants to use my microphone. I have to say, yes, you're allowed to do that. And then I say, okay, my name is Vaughn Cook, and I am 6'1". I used to have blonde hair. I have blue eyes. I am an old guy. And, okay, it's now recorded the energy out of my voice, and it's now making the recording, or processing it, I should say. And remember, the words I've spoken have not been recorded. It's just the energy that comes out of my voice. This will sometimes take a little bit of time, but now it's done, and it says, okay, recording is successful. If you're happy with it, click continue, and if you want to re-record. So let's say that during my recording, I got distracted, or maybe the dog started barking, or there was a loud noise, and I say, I'd like to do that over again. I can hit continue, and it'll take me back. I mean, I can hit re-record, and it'll take me back. If I hit continue, then it moves on to the next thing. So this image is an image that's created from the voice pattern I just, that was just recorded. And what's going to happen now is this image will appear 5 times on the screen, and each time it appears, I'm going to click on it. Or if I was doing this on my phone or my tablet, I would just touch the screen. So I'll click continue once, twice, 3, 4, 5 times. That is the kinetic response that we talked about. So now the scan has been complete. It's fast. And you can see that by each of these items, there is a percentage. And that percentage number is the result of the spark scan. And it tells me that manganese is 80%, vitamin B2 is 85, and so on. And you'll notice over here on the right side, these check marks, the top 10 items are checked by default. If I click on this one, it'll click everything on, or I can turn everything off. And the items that have the check marks in them, those are the ones that will be included in my info boost. Now, if you scroll down, you'll see that all of these items are the items that are in the info boost by default. But some of these get pretty low marks, like here's a 17% and a 19%. If I want to see additional items, I just click on this screen, and you'll see of all of the items in the Limbic Arc library, these are the results. So Shisandra got a 99%. Scroll back up to the top on this, and you'll notice that, well, there's manganese, that's 88%. So Shisandra was higher. So what I'd like to do is I'll take the top items here. So let's take I'm probably going to go down here to the 73. So anything that's 70% or above in the designated group, I'm going to select. Then I'm going to scroll down here to the rest of the group, and I'm going to take these items that are in the top. And I think what I'm going to take here is potassium, watercress, butcher's broom. I'm just going to take down to here. Now, this is purely based on just experience or decision, or you could just base it on the numbers. You could say, hey, we're going to take anything that goes 80 or above or 90 or above down here. But now I've created the items that are going to be in my info boost. I've selected them, and I hit activate. And would you like to set up the notifications? I say, yes, I'd like to set those up. Now, these notifications, they'll happen. I've got it actually set up with my phone number in there, and so I'll be getting those. In the U.S. and in Canada, you get these on text messages. We don't have that built in for countries outside of Canada or the U.S. For a number of reasons. It's not done yet. Okay, so the boost is active, and if I go back to active info boost, you can see I've got focus, and I've got it set up to run for 6 days, so it'll end in 6 days. But that's how the Spark scan works. Now, if I wanted to go in and build another custom info boost or, you know, a similar experience, I don't need a new Spark, because the Spark I created is active, or it's valid for 24 hours. After 24 hours, I would have to go back and create a new Spark. And the software will guide me through that.